We all know that concrete is widely used building material in the construction world. The properties of concrete generally depends on the mixing of concrete ingredients, that is cement, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate and water. The whole world wishes their structure to be strong and durable, and for that they always design their structure according to their desired strength and service. Strength gives an overall indication of quality of concrete, as it is directly related to the lifelong performance of the concrete structure. The strength of the concrete can be measured with the different tests that are conducted on it, such as compressive strength, tensile strength, flexural strength. Apart from this test, there are various factors that also affect the strength of concrete. So today we are going to learn about the different factors that can affect the strength of concrete. So let's start. Number one is water-cement ratio. The ratio of the weight of water to the weight of cement is called water-cement ratio. It is the most important factor for gaining the strength of concrete. The lower water-cement ratio leads to the higher strength of concrete. Generally, the water-cement ratio of 0.45 to 0.60 is used. Too much water leads to segregation and voids in concrete. You can check this chart. When the water-cement ratio is increased, the strength of concrete gets decreased. And when water-cement is decreased, then the strength of concrete increases. It means water-cement ratio is inversely proportional to the strength of concrete. Number two is compaction of concrete. Compaction of concrete increases the density of the concrete because it is the process in which air voids are removed from freshly pressed concrete, which makes the concrete compact and dense. The presence of air voids in concrete greatly reduces its strength. Approximately 5% of air voids can reduce the strength by 30 to 40% of the concrete. As we can see in this chart, even at the same water-cement ratio, strength is different with different compaction accuracies. In the fully compacted concrete, strength is higher than the insufficient compacted concrete. Next is ingredients of concrete. The main ingredients of concrete are cement, sand, aggregates and water. Quality of each material affects the strength of concrete. All materials, therefore, should fulfill the standard criteria for using concrete, like type and quality of cement, types and quality of aggregate, quality of water, all of these. Next is curing of concrete. Curing of concrete is the most essential to prevent plastic shrinkage, temperature control, strength development, and durability. Curing provides the desired moisture and temperature at the depth and near the surface after placing and finishing of concrete for development of strength. In other words, curing provides sufficient water to concrete for completing the hydration process without interruption, which is important for strength development. Commonly, 7 days curing corresponds to 70% of the compressive strength. Curing period depends on the types of cement and the nature of work. Generally, it's about 7 to 14 days for ordinary Portland cement. Hence, please remember, use as less water as possible during concrete mixing and use as more as possible after concreting. There are many methods of curing like ponding and immersion, spraying, fogging and saturated wet covering, etc. I have already made a detailed video on curing of concrete. Link is given in the description of this video. You can go and watch it. Next factor is the shape of aggregate. There are many shapes of aggregates like angular, cubical, elongated, elongated flaky, irregular and rounded. Angular aggregates are roughly textured and rounded aggregates are smoothly textured. Thus, the rounded aggregates create the problem of lack of bonding between cement paste and aggregate. Angular aggregates exhibit a better interlocking effect in concrete, but the angular aggregate contains a large amount of voids. For this, you needed well-graded aggregate. The shape of aggregates becomes more important in case of high strength and high performance of concrete, where very low water-cement ratio is used. In such cases, cubical shape aggregates with high grading are required for better workability. Next is maximum size of aggregate. Large size aggregates gives a lower strength because they have a lower surface area for development of gel bond, which is responsible for strength. Large size aggregate makes concrete heterogeneous. It will not distribute loading uniformly when stressed. Due to internal bleeding, the problem of development of the microcracks in concrete happens when larger size aggregates are used in concrete. Next is grading of aggregates. Grading of aggregates determines the particle size distribution of aggregates. It is the most important factor for concrete mix. There are three types of graded aggregate. That is gap graded aggregate, poorly graded aggregate and well graded aggregate. Well graded aggregate contains all size of particles of aggregate so that they have a less amount of voids. The use of well graded aggregate gives higher strength to the concrete. Now next is weather condition. Weather condition also affects the strength of concrete due to different reasons. In cold climate, exterior concrete is subjected to repeated freezing and thawing action due to the sudden change in weather. It produces deterioration in concrete. With the change in moisture content, materials expand and compact. Hence, it produced cracks in concrete. Number 9 is temperature. With the certain degree of temperature increases, the rate of hydration process increases in it, which gains strength rapidly. Sudden temperature changes create a thermal gradient, which causes cracking and spalling of concrete, so that the final strength of concrete is lower at the very high temperature. Number 10 is the rate of loading. The strength of concrete increases with the increase in the rate of loading because at the high rates of loading, there is less time for creep. Creep produces permanent deformation in the structure at constant loading so that the failure occurs at limiting values of strain rather than the stress. In rapid loading, the load resistance is better than the slow loading. Next is age of concrete. With increase in age of concrete, the degree of hydration would be more. Hydration process is the chemical reaction of water and cement. Hydration produces the gel, which plays a significant role in the bonding of particles of the concrete ingredients. Therefore, the strength of concrete increases with its age. Normally, concrete strength gets doubled after 11 years, if there are no adverse factors. So, all this knowledge about factors which affects the concrete strength is helpful in many ways, particularly during designing the structure, choosing material for concrete, observing precaution for different weather condition, choosing different methods for concreting, aiming better life of building structure, for low maintenance of building after construction, longer durability and better serviceability. So, this is all about the factors that affects the strength of concrete. I hope you all have gained some knowledge from this video. Share it with your friends to help them. Till then, Jai Hind.